first thing you would do carnivore diet, guys. Your face would change. You would go from being more roundish or puffy to a thinner face. Like, even with my face, you can see this before and after. My face actually was roundish, and now it's not. So you'll see it in your face, and you'll definitely see it in your midsection. So the reason why you lose fat in the midsection is because your liver is releasing fat. When you cut out sugar, the body is now forced to live off fat fuel, because sugar and fat fuel are the only two fuel sources in the body. Given the choice, the body always will burn sugar over fat. When you cut that sugar out, you're left only with fat fuel, forcing your body to use up the fat reserves, starting with your liver. All right, the second thing that's going to happen, there's four main organs that are going to be affected when you cut out sugar, more than other organs, okay? Your eyes are definitely going to improve. You have less blurriness, you'll see better. See, the eyes are very sensitive to sugar. This is why diabetics develop a condition called diabetic retinopathy, okay? Destruction of the retina. That's the main nerve in the back of the eye. So your eyes will improve, the kidneys will improve. The kidney is another organ that gets hammered with too much sugar. This is why you might end up with sugar in the urine, protein in the urine, because the sugar is creating a lot of inflammation and kind of rusting out the pipes, like your blood vessels that go right through the kidney to be filtered. And this is what is called diabetic nephropathy. Neph meaning nephron, which is the little filtering thing in your kidney. So basically, you'll have better kidney function. And then we have your arteries. If there's too much sugar, they call that diabetic artery disease or vascular disease. And so when you cut the sugar out, the inflammation in your arteries, all that rusting effect by that excess glucose will kind of start healing again. And because sugar not only converts to fat, but cholesterol too, you'll see your cholesterol values improve dramatically. Then we get to the nerves and the brain. When you take sugar out of your diet, your nerves start healing up. If you have a diabetic condition called peripheral neuropathy, where the ends of your nerves and the bottom of your feet are being destroyed, that will start going away. But also, since there's a lot of nerves in your brain starts healing. And there's two main things in the brain that will improve. First, cognitive function, so your memory is better, your focus is better, and your concentration is much better. You're going to find that your mood is just completely changed. You're going to be much happier. Mind-blowing to me, and I'm trying to understand this. Like diabetes, for example, right? What is diabetes? That is a disease of too much sugar in your blood, right? The obvious approach would be to eat less sugar if you're diabetic, right? I mean, if diabetes is too much sugar in the blood, why not decrease the sugar in your blood? But maybe I'm missing something, because if you look this up medically, you look at what causes diabetes, they're going to say two things, lifestyle and genetics. Okay? And with lifestyle, they say it's, it could be obesity, it could be a lack of exercise, or, and this is a good one, urbanization. I guess moving to the city increases your risk of becoming diabetic. But they're not mentioning too much dietary sugar. Just whack. Instead, they say it's eating too much saturated fat. But that data has been completely debunked, and I will put a video, a couple things down below you can check out. If you still had even a hint of thought that it's the saturated fat, it's not. It's the carbs. And then they dig a little bit further regarding the poor diet. They actually tell you to maintain high levels of grain in your diet. Now, they won't say whole grains, but even whole grains are like 85% carbohydrate. Maybe you can help me out. I don't know if it's just obvious to me or why other people are not getting this, but it's just so simple. You cut the sugar out if you have diabetes. All right, the next thing you're going to notice is you're going to get up a lot less during the night. Okay? Why is that? Because water bubbles sugar. Okay? So if you're eating sugar and it's going through your blood, it's getting filtered through the kidney, you're going to find that that's going to trigger more urination, especially at night. And one simple solution is just start cutting out the sugar, and you will find you're going to get up a lot less during the night. I mean, when I was in practice, I had people get up 10 times a night and eat. And all we did is cut the sugar out, and they slept the entire night. Now, it does take a few weeks, but to salvage your sleep is so important. All right, next thing that's going to improve is your energy. Well, like I said before, there's two types of fuel you can run your body on. Sugar
1700 calories of stored sugar. So if we were to give you an analogy, it would be like having this huge car battery to run on versus this little AAA battery. If you're going to run your entire body on this little AAA battery, you're going to be constantly hungry, craving, ups and downs with your energy. But when you're burning fat, you no longer are susceptible to the ups and downs of this sugar, and especially the ups and downs of this energy fatigue cycle. I mean, think about this. Between the meals, right, your body should live on fat. An average person with the standard American diet cannot even tap into the fat because there's too much sugar in the bloodstream. So by dropping the sugar, converting your body over to fat fuel, you are going to be running on fat constantly between eating as well as your fat when you eat. And so that's going to give you a tremendous amount of steady-state energy on a whole day. And your brain is going to feel a lot better. And this relates to the next point, craving. The reason why your appetite goes away between meals is because even though you're not eating anything, okay, your body is eating its own fat between the meals. So if it's eating between the meals, it's being satisfied, and you're not going to be hungry. The only way to achieve that is by cutting down your sugar as well as not eating so
frequently,
like meals. So how do you get rid of the craving for sugar? By not eating sugar. This process takes about 3 days. And it's not that hard. Anyone can do this. You just have to bite the bullet and jump right in. But you want to reduce your carbs to less than 50 grams per day. That includes the fruits. It includes honey and a lot of the other hidden sugars as other carbs like the bread, pasta, cereal, crackers, biscuits, waffles, things like that. I mean, an average person, at least in the U.S., consumes, on average, about 13.5 teaspoons of added sugar every single day. That comes out to 54 grams of sugar for those of you in Europe. Now, that's added sugar. What about the sugar in the other carbs, like the bread, pasta, cereal, crackers, biscuits, waffles, pancakes, muffins, alcoholic beverages, wine and beer, and sodas, and the juices, etc. That comes out to
okay, guys. Tidak mampu kasih habis 1 kilo, guys. Sakit saudara aku gigit. Kurang half lah. 500 gram lah gitu. Next time. Jumpa lagi. Aku try lagi kasih habis next time. Alright, goodbye.